Bobby Evox had a foul. Scott Pollard with number six. So Pollard is fouled out. And here comes Lonnie Evox, who has four.
Shaq on the move, wearing Scott Pollard out. Scott's already bailing out on the play. That's not a foul. I'm sorry.
Screen and roll. Now they'll reverse the try. The combo's illegal. He's just camping out in the middle.
Oh, Steve Smith picks up foul number two. Michael knocks the basket in. Here comes Eldridge with Kasner at the scorer's bench. Here's Michael. He gives a little fake. That was kind of phantom, wasn't it?
Never put me on his beat. Okay, yeah. I'm a baller.
New Joe Budden, we back. Score NBA.
On top.
That's
jump
on. The
beat.
Queens.
Stand up.
Nitty.
Jump on. You rap guys, it's a joke. I'm here to take the scoring title without the green light from my coach. Man, don't make me have to smack your lineup. I'm Michael Jordan, y'all Harold Miners that rap Regina. All black, ski mask, gloves, tuck the thing. Drive slow, lights out like I love this game. See, I live this, y'all paint that pic. And y'all like magic, I'm starting to believe your dudes ain't that sick.
Joe, you were strong in the meeting about how David Stern has handled this whole Chris Paul deal. What's your issue with it?
I'd like to take it a step further. It may be time to consider David Stern moving on to other ventures now.
Well,
strong. Why?
Yeah.
Just because of this?
Not solely because of this.
Yeah.
I feel like for starters, during the NBA lockout, it was horrible customer service. I felt like they had absolutely no regard for the consumer.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like basketball has horrid officiating. Out of all the sports that require replay, that have replay involved, the officiating is horrible.
Yeah.
It's an insult. It's an insult to watch. I think this goes back to the referee. The referee, Tim
Donaghy.
Tim Donaghy, right. Scamming on games. I think it's a
until this stretch, he has not had the touch. Now, how about this? Under pressure, he's able to play the board and knock it in.
And again, he'll go to the line. He's 18 of 22 from the line.
It's unlike a Barry to pass that up.
Absolutely.
And a foul on Diaw, trying to help out. That's his third. Second team foul.
Stoudemire will sit for a while with his four fouls. Barbosa comes in.
Like Tim Duncan might have shot the right hip out there a little bit on Boris, but we know he's not going to get his fourth call.
Let's go to Craig with Phil Jackson.
Well, Coach, a terrific start that led to a 14-point lead at one point, but it's down to five. What changed those last few minutes for you guys?
You want me to be honest with you?
Yes.
You guys are the whistles.
Keep Kobe a little fresher in the second quarter.
And Mato Ginobili remains as the defender on Bryant. That's an offensive foul. No, it's a travel. Traveling violation called on Walton.
Bryant in game one had 7 points in the first quarter. We're seeing that Derek Fisher here tonight.
And for Fisher, that's his first.
Up eight, they want to rest Kobe to start the second quarter, so they'd like to have a nice cushion. Here's an offensive foul on Luke Walton, so we've seen him with a travel here early and an offensive foul. And last couple minutes here important for the Lakers, because when Kobe rests, you'd like to have a lead when your second unit is on the floor. Actually, their power forward out there right now, they've gone to that small lineup to get some three-point shooting with Duncan.
And a foul is called on Farmar. Pushing foul. Lakers over the limit. The Lakers. Bryant leading Gasol, but the pass behind him. And out of bounds.
Great weak side defense that time.
Nice pass from Bryant. Walton came up short. Udoka. For Duncan. Oh! Tim Duncan. Taking to the rim, Phil Jackson cannot believe that he was not called on a travel. So the Spurs are within five. What do you think, Doug?
I think the Spurs have to be very happy because they did not play well in that first period, and they're only down five.
How excited are you about this New York-Boston rivalry maybe heating up?
It's a rivalry? Man, y'all let me in on all the new stuff all the time. I didn't know we had a rivalry going.
Here it comes. Felton on him right now. Garnett the screen. Pierce driving on Stoudemire. The jumper, yes! With 0.4 of a second left.
Official made the call late, and he's telling Mike D'Antoni to get back. Now, what happens a lot on this, the official along the baseline, and this is Greg Willard, who's right there, but sometimes it's what officials call you get eaten up on the play. You're so close you may not see it. Donahue perhaps giving Willard a chance to make the call. He didn't, but it didn't look like there was much there.
No, I don't know what he saw. Tim Donahue making the call.